Do I have to use this?
Hey, who's there?
Hey, hold on!
Ah, he got me out of... Damn it. This is getting impossible.
Hey, hold it!
There's three... No, there's two, right? Go searching for me. Go down the hall or something. Just stop hanging around there. Maybe they will. Stuff's pretty interesting around here. I don't dare stand up to get a better look at it. I got the code, I just need to get in.
Someone there?
Hey, there you are!
I would have fed on him too, but he was running. Are these cameras disabled? I think so. I hope I find a quicker way out of here. Oh! You've gotta be kidding me. Trying to see if that person's coming down this hallway. How would I get past this? Oh, there's someone right there as well. CCTV in operation. We see you touching all that stuff. Well, I did not see anything around here to turn this stuff off. Fuse box. I mean, maybe if I jump over it? Let me just see something. If I jump, oh, sneaking. I guess it is possible. I'm probably gonna fail at it though. Tell you that much. So be ready to run. Nope. Can't go through there. Security is this way.
Hey, who's there?
Chair. Beams. Platypus. Hope he doesn't walk this way while I'm in here. Beams. Disable. Alarm. Bat. Alarm siren disabled. Oh, he's got the key card at his feet.
Someone there?
I need blood. Well, that doesn't help. I hate to use my last regular blood bag, but... Exit. Huh. No exit for me.
Someone there?
Huh?
Hey, hold it!
No holdings.
Freeze!
I'm stuck. I can't move. God damn it. I had to go out of sneaking to... Fraught with problems. Fraught with problems. Now he's back in my way. Let me go through there. I don't suppose there's a way around all this to get past him. Hello?
Oh. I can't understand why someone would go through the trouble of stealing a box with a very ancient corpse. This city's not that dull.
Beckett! What are you doing here? And what happened to the Ankaran sarcophagus? And what are you talking about? But what are you doing here?
I'm an archaeologist, so I thought I'd indulge in a quick study of this Ankaran sarcophagus everyone's so riled up about. My guess, from what I've read about it, is that it's a mummified Mesopotamian king. I needed confirmation.
What happened to the sarcophagus?
Since it's missing, I'm inclined to believe it was stolen, or intentionally misplaced, if you like. Clearly, though, it's not here.
Indeed. Did you get to examine it at all?
Oh, I really wish I had. All this speculation about the sarcophagus containing an antediluvian and being a portent of Gehenna is making me cringe.
Third generation.
These are the kinds of ridiculous, superstitious assumptions I came here to debunk.
Antediluvians. Yeah, I'll ask him about that, although I know from the little loading screen text that it's a third generation of vampires, very, very powerful.
No one I know has ever met one. But each of the clans and their bloodlines supposedly trace their origin to an original vampire, an antediluvian. Some swear these grandsires still exist into the present. But then, kindred and kind believe a lot of strange things.
Indeed. And Gehenna? I know the end times of vampires and I think everyone else as well.
Armageddon, doomsday, the end of all kindred. It's a common facet of most mythologies. Fear that the world will end. Many believe Cain and the antediluvians will return to consume or destroy all kindred. I wholeheartedly disagree.
Why do you disagree?
As I said, many cultures have the fear of some form of apocalypse. Kindred believed in these stories when they were human, and naturally carried them over into kindred myth. But it doesn't take a supernatural act to cause widespread destruction. Humans and kindred are just as capable of managing their own destruction as a deity. A self-realized Gehenna warrants more vigilance than a god-induced one, don't you agree?
Yes.
Such is my argument, which so frequently falls on deaf ears.
Well, I'm listening. I'm listening. Are there any other signs of Gehenna?
What prophecy doesn't have vague, apocryphal signs? Let's see. The usual ones cited are the appearance of thin bloods, Cain sightings, doom, gloom, that route.
Yeah, I know who Cain is, obviously. Cain and Abel, and then he was cursed to be the first vampire, which is interesting. I don't remember reading that section of the Bible, but Cain, yeah. Joking, guys.
Cain is the biblical first kindred and founder of the mythological first city, Enoch, a place where kindred and kind coexisted. I believe Cain's a figure concocted to personify the transition from nomadic society to agrarian society. That myth, like most, has been twisted by time.
Kindred and kind coexistent in Enoch. How does that work? Can you tell me more about the Thin Bloods?
Thin Bloods rarely exhibit features or powers of their clan, and many can't embrace. Some are even rumored to have reproduced. Many kindred are terrified that their weak blood heralds the dissipation of every bloodline. Somewhat of an ignorant reactionary response, don't you think?
Yes, I do agree. This is all fascinating stuff. How long have you been studying kindred lore?
For 300 years I've been trying to determine the function of our existence, the kindred's role in the world. I'm not content to attribute it to some act of supernatural biblical vengeance. We exist for a reason. And if it takes another 300, I'll figure it out. Any thoughts?
Stats increased. Ooh. Did I increase research or something? That'd be sweet. Then I can read that book. Yeah. So he's trying to figure out the meaning of life from a kindred, or of the kindred. Mutations with powers like in comic books. Well, mutations with powers like in comic books often are, you know, homo superior, as seen in the X-Men and related comics, are the told to be the next evolution of human beings. Thus the homo sapiens view them with fear. But, yeah, I think we're possibly the next evolution of human beings.
Yes, I've heard that theory before. It certainly seems plausible, but there's little proof to support it. Still, it's a better explanation than a divine sentence for manslaughter.
Hmm. Yeah, I really don't know.
My sentiments exactly. But there's time to rectify that. Well, my work here is stolen away into the night. Think I'll do the same.
Goodbye, Beckett.
It's a nice night out, huh?
Automatically back here, okay. Beckett. He's pretty awesome, isn't he? Well, since we're here. Oh, you know what? Wait. These people will see me. Alright, let's check in on our sweetie since we're here in town.
Sleep next to you? Go ahead and play the radio into bed. That's what I'm here for.
Hey, sweetie.
And hey, why don't you call me sometime? Area code 323-KL5-KTRK.
Is that new?
Looks like somebody's been waiting in the queue quite a while to speak to yours truly. So, caller, why aren't you asleep?
Insects.
Insects? As in you have an insect problem? Or chirping crickets are
just listen to us, I'll be right with you.
Or you have nightmares about them. Help me out here.
No. Don't you know? When you fall asleep, they can crawl into your mouth or your ears or your nose. You can't prevent it if you're asleep. I mean, what can you do?
Are there any scientists out there listening to this?
I read something. I don't know where. But do you know the average person eats several pounds of insects a year? The majority of that weight is composed of roaches, ants, and spiders. Just knowing that as soon as you close your eyes, a big fat centipede is going to drop into your mouth and crawl down your throat. I can't do it. I never sleep at night.
You know, they voluntarily eat insects in some countries.
Yeah, well, those countries probably need Jesus.
So, you never sleep at night. I assume you do sleep, right?
I sleep at work.
And what exactly do you do?
I'm a middle school teacher.
That would explain why my nephew invested that 20 I sent him for his birthday on magic beans. It's always good to know that the future of our country is in good hands, isn't it? Oh, boy. Let's see who else we got. Caller, what do you do for them?
I'm Roger.
Okay, and what do you do, Roger?
I'm a writer, Deb.
So, have you written any movies I might have seen?
Well, I actually haven't finished any screenplays yet.
I see. So, have you done any other kinds of writing?
Well, just some outlines right now, but I've got some really good ideas for some stories that are crawling around in the old noggin.
So, if you haven't really written anything, how can you call yourself a writer? Because I once fixed my toilet doesn't make me a plumber, right?
What do you think?
Oh. Is there anyone in this city that doesn't call themselves a writer or actor or director? Don't you think you're doing a disservice to those who actually make their living in those art forms by deeming yourself something you're not or not even trained to do?
No, I think I'm pretty good at knowing what's good writing from bad writing.
Well, wouldn't that make you a critic? Let's see if anyone else agrees. Line two. Are you ready for a menage a trois?
Sure thing, Deb.
And would you please state what you do for a living?
I'm a personal assistant for a producer at Parasite Studios.
Perfect. Do you read a lot of screenplays?
Don't get me started.
Well, for our writer on the phone, here's your big chance to feature screenplays.
Parasite Studios.
Is that okay, line two?
Sell me, dude.
Well, okay. So, my story's about this guy.
You don't say.
Okay, so this guy, he's like an FBI agent, but, you know, he doesn't really work for the main FBI. And, he's got this partner who's new and really cute, but she's also a really good agent. And they're, like, assigned to this bizarre case where people are being killed in really strange ways.
X-Files.
And then, like, something happens and the girl agent gets kidnapped by the killer.
Something happens.
Yeah, well, I haven't quite figured it out yet, but, like, the guy agent notices, like, how the killer seems know everything he's doing, like, one step ahead of him. And then there's this kind of, you know, weird chase scene. And then, like, we find out that the guy's got two personalities. And, like, he finds out in the end that he's the killer. And then he's kidnapped his own partner.
Well, line two, what do you think? You're gonna option it or not?
Writer dude?
Roger.
Roger, would you like my professional opinion?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Wisconsin.
Okay. I want you to get all your stuff together, and then I want you to move back to Wisconsin.
That's a little cold, line two.
That's Hollywood, baby.
She should talk.
Good for you.
No, dude, it's not.
Break it up, you two. Huh. Final thoughts, guys?
Wisconsin.
I have some other things I'm working on.
Wisconsin?
I have some pretty good ideas for video games, I think. If anyone's interested in hiring me, my number is 213.
Sorry, Roger. The only one that gets to give out their number on this show is me.
Huh?
If anyone was thinking of asking what I'm wearing, that number again is 323-KL5-KTK. We're going to take a short commercial break, but that doesn't mean you can stop thinking about me. Don't go anywhere, boys.
Does your penis always seem to be getting in the way?
I got the last of the groceries, honey. I just need to close the trunk.
This birdhouse would be as good as new.
Yo!
I'm sorry, sir. This dressing room is for women only.
You don't have to let this happen to you. Hi, I'm Dr. Fred Tuck. Don't let your penis interfere with the quality of your life anymore. I have performed over 300 sex changes in my career, and not one of my patients has ever asked for their tackle box back. Come to Tuck's Sex Exchange in the next month, and I'll give you a free estimate. Don't let your peace interfere with your peace of mind.
Tuck's Sex Exchange, located off Beverly Drive. Look for the sign with two, the surgical saw.
Tired of sluggish internet access?
Mom! The internet's all slow again.
I'm not your mom. I'm the creature that evolved out of your mom.
Sick of unwanted spam.
Oh, another email message from my old college roommate, Rod Hughes. Oh my.
Computer problems make it frustrating to log on?
Error 432, network access remote server memory allocation assessment table exceeded. Hard drive reformatting will now commence. What?
Looking for something that requires no logons, no unwanted email, coherent sentences, and no technical problems whatsoever? Read a book. Books. The original internet.
Terrorists are prepared to destroy the largest dam in America. Again.
Then she bomb goes off. This Hoover will be caught with his panties down.
And only this renegade cop and his ex-wife's manicurist stand between destruction and unexpected love.
I'll just file you as DOA.
This summer, all bets are off. The heat is on.
Get it, file.
The fix is in. The dogs are out. The game is up. The chips are down. The stakes are high. The odds are low. The danger is huge.
Oh, brother.
The payoff is slim.
I'm reading
friendships
it.
will be made, rules will be broken, wrongs will be righted, and no unturned stone will be left.
Unturned.
Get ready to be turned inside out and upside down.
What? Turned.
Hoover 2, Hydroelectric Boogaloo. The best damn movie you'll see this year.
When I'm grinding the reverse Poindexter 540 to Ollie northbound the contraband, I can't think about being bloated. That's why every morning I down a Pound Growl, the gentle extreme laxing sports drink. Because when you're playing a Wicked Skullcross 720, you don't want anything to slow you down.
Wicked Skullcross 720. Mm.
The moon is out, everyone's in dreamland, and you've turned into the dead of night. Nobody to fall asleep next to? Go ahead and pull the radio into bed. That's what I'm here for. And hey, why don't you call me sometime? Area code 323-KL5.
Think that's it.
Looks like somebody's been waiting in the queue quite a while to speak to yours truly. So, caller, why aren't you asleep?
Insects.
Hey, sweetie.
Oh, you're back. I went out this evening and I... Well, I met someone and he wouldn't leave me alone, so I... He came back here with me and... Well, I thought you might want to, you know, want to drink his blood.
What?
Are there any scientists out there listening to this?
I read something. I don't know where.
What are you doing going out meeting people? Thought you were in love with me. What the hell? So you did what? Where is he?
In the bathroom. I locked him in. Did I mess up?
So you never sleep at night. I assume you do sleep, right?
I'll deal with this. You stay here.
And
you stay here.
What exactly do you do?
Really? Locked him in the bathroom?
If you invested that 20 I sent in for his birthday on magic beans.
The hell?
Hey, what the hell is this shit? Let me out, goddammit. I'll kill that crazy bitch.
Caller, what do you do for me?
You'll do no such thing.
As soon as I get out of here, I'm calling the goddamn cops. Let's see what they think of this, huh? I'll have them lock up both your asses.
I might have seen.
Well, I actually haven't finished any screenplays yet.
I see. So, have you done any other kinds of writing?
Maybe I could use a drink. Yeah, I could use a drink.
What the hell does that mean? Wait, why are you looking at me like that? Hey!
If you haven't really written anything,
come here. I got a secret to tell you.
Because I once fixed my toilet doesn't make me a plumber. Is there anyone in this city that doesn't call themselves a writer, or actor, or director? Don't you think you're doing a disservice to those who are forms by deeming yourself something you're not?
So now what do I do? I can just kill him, right?
I'm pretty good at knowing what's good writing from bad writing.
Well, wouldn't that make you a critic? Let's see if anyone else agrees. Mine too.
I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to do.
Sure thing, Deb.
And would you please state what you do for me?
I'm a personal...
Master?
I fed on him, but let him live. Get him out as long as the trance is lasting.
Is that okay?
I wish I could tell her to not do that again.
I promise it'll be done by the time you get back.
My story's about this guy.
You don't say.
Okay, so this guy, he's... Well, he's like a...
See that it is.
FBI agent, but, you know, he doesn't really work for the main FBI. And, he's got this partner who's new and really cute, but she's also...
So... Can I just go like this? Just pretend I've been walking around town. Because I really don't have anything else to do here.
Nobody to fall asleep next to you? Go ahead and pull the radio into bed.
Master?
And hey, why don't you call me sometime? Area code 323-KL5-KTRK. Looks like somebody's been waiting in the queue.
He's gone. Don't be bringing guys back here. Don't be meeting guys, period. What the hell?
As in you have an insect problem? Or tripping...
I am not polyamorous. I don't knock people who are of it. I am not. Here, I got an email. A gambit. A gambit has been played. The king leaves himself open.
Are there any scientists?
Okay, is he talking about LaCroix?
I read something. I don't know where. But do you know the average person eats several pounds of insects a year? The majority of that weight is composed of frozen...
Email.
Just knowing that as soon as you close your eyes, a big fat centipede is going to drop into your mouth and crawl down your throat. I can't do it.
See, his emails...
You know, they voluntarily eat insects.
Next. Next.
Well, those countries probably need Jesus.
So, no. Never sleep at night.
I assume you do sleep, right? And what exactly do you
So think? Next.
That would explain why my nephew invested that 20 I sent him for his birthday on magic beans.
Yeah, I wish I could go back and reference that those emails, but they're gone.
Oh, let's see who else we got. Power, what do you do? Okay, and...
I just want to see if there's anything new on the television.
Failed to return Wednesday night was found this morning, though without any trace of its operator or passengers. Cambodian officials have dispatched several military units into the area to search through the surrounding jungle amidst concerns that it is related to one of a number of Southeastern Asian terrorist organizations based in the region. Three American citizens are among the missing. Concerned parent groups joined several senators on the step of Capitol Hill to protest the latest wave of violent video games. Senator Limperman called the games pornography and was offended by crude shots taken at him by one recent game. Among the titles the group is trying to get banned from stores are Mangle Garden, Rape and Pillage, and Abe Lincoln Teaches Killing. Protesters say that extended media attention towards exploitive games such as Meth Tycoon promotes parental awareness of their adult content and lessens children's interest in the taboo-themed games. Religious tourists have been flocking in droves to the Santa Maria Church in Santiago, Spain, after several pilgrims claim to have seen statues of the Madonna begin crying blood. The site dates back to the period of the Romans and has several reported weeping virgin sightings throughout its history. One pilgrim reported that they witnessed blood coming from no less than six statues at around sunset, and that the courtyard felt full of sadness. Skeptics have been quick to point out that this phenomena has been debunked, and witnesses are no more credible than those that report UFOs. The search for an L.A. sewer worker is beginning to look grim as police and family end their seventh night looking for Luis Salvador after he failed to return home last Friday. Salvador was last seen entering a manhole in Hollywood to carry out a routine inspection. Salvador's family is hopeful that the husband and father of three will return safely and urge anyone who might have seen Salvador to contact the police. The Southland Slasher struck again, this time in downtown Los Angeles. The body of Sean Milton, a former convict that was recently released for good behavior, was found butchered, similarly to the other victims of the serial killer. Police believe there may be a connection between Milton's prison past and the slasher. We'll have a full report on this story later tonight. Simon Milligan, host of local cable show Haunted LA, and his crew are reported missing tonight.
Yeah.
The team of the popular supernatural-themed program were filming around downtown Los Angeles, according to the show's producer. But friends and family of the crew started to worry when they failed to return from a night of shooting. No trace has been found yet of the Haunted LA team, and rumors by the show's fans speculate the crew met a supernatural end, though police disagree and have started a sweep of the areas where the crew was filming. A tourist bus destined for the ancient city.
Okay, yeah.
What do you do, Roger?
I'm a writer. Master?
So have you written any movies? I need your blood, at least some of it.
So, if you haven't really written anything, how can you call yourself a writer?
See you later.
Because I once fixed my toilet doesn't make me a...